Now, we wanted to learn more about the move over law and how it impacts law enforcement every day. 27 First News reporter Molly Reed joins us live tonight with that story. Molly?
Yeah, that's right, Dave and Erica. I'm standing here on an overpass above the 680 where sometimes you'll see a cop pulling someone over on the side of the road with their lights on. Now, the move over law is in place to protect those people, yet every year, hundreds of people across the nation are hit by another driver breaking that law. Today, when I rode along with Sergeant Robinson from Ohio State Highway Patrol, he showed me just how many close calls they have in a day. Pulling someone over for a traffic violation on the side of a busy interstate can be dangerous for officers. Cars are flying by, sometimes at speeds of up to 80 miles per hour. Sergeant Philip Robinson has been in law enforcement for almost 20 years and says stepping out of his car is always risky.
When you get on the interstate or on a divided highway like State Route 11, just because of the sheer volume of traffic, you will have your fair share of close calls.
From 2011 to 2015, there were 67 Ohio State Highway Patrol cruisers involved with move over law related crashes. That led to more than 90 injuries and 2 deaths. Today I took a ride with Sergeant Robinson just to see how big the problem is. He said Northeast Ohio has been one of the worst areas in the state for people breaking the move over law recently.
You always have to have your head on a swivel to make sure that you're seeing every car that comes past you, just to make sure that you don't get hit.
On some of our traffic stops, several people blatantly sped past, so they got stopped next.
You have to move over to that left lane so as not to cause a crash.
Okay, I didn't know that, I'm sorry.
Sergeant Robinson said the law is in all 50 states, so saying you didn't know is not an excuse. He said in the force, you see people and their families affected by people ignoring this law, and sometimes it's not because of what occurred, but what could have.
And then, of course, we have other incidents where the worst does happen. At that point, you just have to get that message out there to everyone that they need to move over. They need to slow down anytime they see the lights on the side of the road.
Now, Sergeant Robinson also said that if you can't move over, you need to be able to slow down so the cops can see that you blatantly slowed down enough for them to still stay safe. For now in Youngstown, Molly Reed, WKBN 27 First News.